Hi, check out my new Reddit channel where I read the best Reddit stories, breakups, crazy ex, and much more. Link is down in the description. Like and subscribe in the next 5 seconds to receive a week of good luck. So like and subscribe. r/askreddit. Redditors who were head over heels in love with their s/o but got divorced. What went wrong? Together 7 years, married 2, high school sweetheart for me. It wasn't the one thing, it was a combination that slowly broke every piece of the relationship. We had opposite schedules and struggled with communication because of it. He had goals at work but wasn't very motivated to reach them and was very naive. Because of that, there was always pressure when we were together to be happy and do things which he would never plan. He would never take the initiative on anything, leaving all of the decisions to me. He constantly put his family above me, which put additional pressure on the situation. They aren't exactly stable, and he did absolutely nothing to draw boundaries or put me first. He had no respect for me or my feelings, and once I realized this and started calling him out for the stuff he was doing, saying terrible shit, then apologizing for it, getting caught in small white lies because he's just telling me what I want to hear, belittling me and my interests slash passions, he would either pout for hours or say something shitty to me. He only complimented me during sex. He was selfish and showed no interest in any of my interest, and after a few years it really began to show how one-sided things were. I wanted to do a career change which would put us financially strained for a bit. I was supporting us but wanted to become a teacher because I want to give back. How terrible of me, right? And he asked me to wait a few years. One of the final straws was when he told me he had been lying about his sexual history for our entire relationship and to all his friends, even after we had a full amnesty confession before we got married. His line was always, "I could never look you in the eyes and lie to you." After that, I didn't know what to do. He had broken the last solid bit we had in our relationship, trust. I was in therapy dealing with anxiety and depression that were affecting me superficially as well, when he realized how much I was looking past in the name of love and how much I had been putting up with. I was turning to him for support, and he was too selfish to understand how to help me. He could only do or think of things that he would want or that would make him feel better. He did the bare minimum but made it seem like he was bending over backwards and made me feel guilty about things all the time. I was doing so much work on myself that I started to notice how terrible he was making me feel. That allowed me to see how bad the relationship had really become. I was always afraid of having even bad thoughts about him because I loved him so much, and divorce was never an option. But once I realized everything he was doing, I got so mad. I was able to see past that, realize I deserve somebody who is capable of putting someone else first, and he wasn't capable of being that person. It was shitty. Like, really shitty. I had switched jobs a few months before the split because I knew I was going to get laid off and my new job was 30 miles away. After the split, I moved. She got closer to work while he stayed in town. I didn't realize this at the time, but this meant he had to control the story. I became the dumb bitch who left him for somebody at my work. He became the victim. He denied starting the rumors, of course, because he was still so distraught over the split he could never say anything terrible about me. I lost 90% of my friends, who I guess we are not really good friends, a ton of money because I supported him the entire relationship and my early 20s. He didn't even let me say goodbye to the dog. So we fortunately never got married, but I was hopelessly in love with my last boyfriend and our relationship was going great. At the time where this whole shit show went down, we were planning on moving in together. We would have to take out a small loan to pay the deposit, and I agreed to put in my name since he had some debt already and couldn't get accepted for a loan. We would split the costs of paying it off, of course, and I trusted him completely. We had written ourselves up for a bunch of apartments in our area, also in my name. However, he decided he'd rather cheat on me with his best friend and leave me for her, none of which he told me about. Of course, he claimed his mental health had deteriorated so badly he had a mental breakdown and would have to be admitted, and just didn't feel he was in any state to be in a relationship at the moment. I was very sad about this, but ultimately I told him that I understood, and that I was glad we could end things amicably. I went out to the pub to drown my sorrows, and met one of our mutual friends. She hugged me, and told me how sorry she was, and that she thought it was very inappropriate of him to move on so quickly. I confusedly asked her what she meant, and she got this shocked expression on her face, and asked me, "You mean, you don't know?" Turns out he had made a new Facebook account, blocked me from it, and announced his relationship with her on the same day that he had broken up with me, and then continued to message me from his old account like nothing was wrong. After I finished sobbing, I messaged him asking for an explanation. At first he tried to deny everything, but eventually broke and admitted he had cheated with her and just suddenly developed feelings for her and blamed everything on drugs and his father's suicide. The kicker is that he had cheated with her at a party where I was passed out drunk in the next room, on our anniversary no less. I sent him a long message with some choice words for him and his new girlfriend, told him I never wanted to see him or speak to him ever again, and donated the stuff he had left at my apartment to the Salvation Army. As a bonus, I later found out he had previously dated one of my friends whom he had also cheated on for months, this time with his ex. At the time I was devastated, of course, but in hindsight it was probably for the better. Imagine if I'd gotten stuck paying for an apartment and loan I couldn't afford, if he had waited just a few more months to leave. I was in love with an illusion of man that never even existed. It was just a well-crafted mask, made for me to fall for him. I thought we are a perfect match, but he only pretended to have the same values and interests as me. We were slow cooking me through his manipulations, isolating me from friends and family, insane jealousy and control. He stole my money, didn't work for a long time himself, had thousand excuses why, slowly took over our finances, and before I realized it, I was in debt that seemed impossible to pay off from my salary alone, at which point he started working, only to pay off minuscule amounts each month, and keeping the rest for himself, drinking and smoking weed and cigarettes every day, while I couldn't buy myself new shoes or clutches as the old ones were worn out or didn't fit me anymore as I gained 20 kilograms from stress eating and loneliness. I stayed with him for 3 years. I thought about this relationship as a prison I need to escape, but many things kept me in check. Him ruining my finances and making it practically impossible to find a new apartment for myself as the acceptable ones were too expensive or were checking my credit score. Him doing something nice and sweet once a month for a change after starting fights, and hurting me mentally for the rest of the time. I was so starved of normalcy and affection that I started having crushes on guys at work who even smiled at me and talked to me like a normal person. But the breaking point was an assault where he sat on my stomach and slapped me multiple times. After a few hours I tried to get a hold of my phone to call the ambulance, but he took it away from me, said I just need to sleep it off, and started calmly listening to music. He thought of it as a lesson for my insubordination as he hugged me forcefully and with a fake cheerful tone said that it's all good now, nothing bad happened, because he knew exactly how he should beat me and not do any real lasting harm. He said that it's an opportunity for us to have a better relationship in the future. Total psycho. Of course I went to the police as soon as I got hold of my phone. Now I don't have any contact with him, blocked him everywhere, and I'm waiting for a mandatory year to pass between the separation and filing for a divorce. Stupid family law, / I want to be free of him now. I'm in a happy relationship, but I have to wait and date while still being married. My ex-wife and I were together for 3 years. I know it's not long. We met online then started dating, then we quickly started living together. She eventually developed a drug habit, opioids, which led her to odd on her bachelorette party. She said she would rather be dead than married to me, and then tried to crash my car by punching me and pulling the steering wheel. Because I took her pills out of her hand as she tried to down the whole bottle, I had to call the cops and get an ambulance to make sure she was safe. That same day they let her out, even though she was inebriated. She jumped out of my car as we were heading home because she wanted to go to her mom's instead. I took her there, and her mom made her go home. I took her home, she passed out, and I gathered all my stuff that I needed and left. I planned on not coming back, but her mom called me and convinced me to give her another chance. I really wish I didn't, but I did. She got clean, cold turkey, and it was hard, but it made me think she was absolutely determined to stay clean and work with me on staying together. But I still had to cook, clean, pay bills, everything. I wouldn't mind do a bit here or there to help out, but it was always me. We got married later that year. Her mom passed away a few weeks after. I honestly still miss her mom to this day. After that we moved, and she got her first job at 26. I had to push her to get it. I told her we will fail if I'm the only one making money. That is when she found out she loved smoking pot. I'm fine with smoking and shit, but she was spending upwards to $1,200 a month, which we really could not afford. I was still doing everything, and with her spending so much I felt like all my work was to just keep us from being homeless, and I guess I was. She also let her dog impregnate my dog when I was gone on a work trip, so when I was home I had to be the one taking care of them and cleaning up after them while she went and partied with her friends. I told her I was thinking of getting a divorce in our second year. I told her this because I wanted to see what we can do to fix our marriage. We saw therapists. I hated all of them. They either dragged us on instead of getting to problem solving, or they only took my side. I see that they did because I was right, but I wanted to know what I could do to fix us. I really should have been looking for how we could. Our last argument started when I found out she spent all of her check in 2 days with nothing to show for it, and I had to pay all the bill, pay for the gas, and everything. The argument escalated when we got home. It was a lot of yelling and name calling. Neither of us were helping. That is when I did something I have never done. When she was leaving mid-argument, I put my fist through a wall. I have never done that. It was not who I was. That is when I knew I needed to just go through with it and get the divorce. I called a lawyer a friend referred me to and set up an appointment in the morning, which was our 3rd year anniversary. I told her I want a divorce. I know it is cold, but I had to do it as soon as I could. I had to stay emotionless when talking with her. But when I wasn't in earshot, I was crying and trying to reassure myself that I had to do this. I took on 10k in debt, and she could take whatever she wanted and needed, except my truck and my dog. It was a rough time getting everything taken care of. I just wish I did it sooner or just never answered the phone when she called. If you are having thoughts of getting a divorce, look at all the red flags, think of what can you fix. But importantly, think about if this is going to be worth the pain and stress of keeping it together. I personally found going emotionally numb to be beneficial when talking with them about it. So this is not my story, but a family friend's. She married her high school sweetheart. They'd been together for 10-ish years, I believe, and before they pulled the trigger on marriage they took a break to make sure it was what they really wanted. After they break they were still in love, so they got married. I went to the wedding, and it was nice. Very fun, and they seemed very into each other. Fast forward 4 years. The marriage still seems to be going smoothly, and the family friend, the bride, decides to go back to school and study for a medical degree, I think. Medical law. The specific degree doesn't matter. Her husband is extremely supportive of the decision and encourages her to go for it. 1 week after she starts school, he tells her that he wants a divorce. She's completely floored and asks him for the reason, but he doesn't really have one. He just said that it's over. She offered to drop out of college immediately, go to marriage counseling, and do whatever was needed to fix the marriage, but he just staunchly refused across the board. So she gave him a final warning. She'd do whatever she could to fix the marriage, but once the paperwork was signed, that'd be it forever period. So she wanted to make sure that he was completely sure it was what he wanted. He confirmed it was. The paperwork was signed, and the marriage was no more. And about a month later, guess who comes crawling back? Smart gal that she is. Our family friend tells him to take a hike. We have a few theories why he wanted the divorce, but nothing concrete. Last I heard, this family friend had gotten engaged again to her new boyfriend of about a year. He's about 10 years younger than her, and her family is understandably concerned. And had along with her fiancé, about whether or not he was sure, making sure that he knew what he was signing up for. Especially with a woman this much older than him, are you still going to love her, when you're pushing 30 and she's 40? They're afraid that she's just in panic mode, because she's 30 now, and doesn't want a life to slip her by, so she's latching onto the first guy she finds, damned of the consequences. Only time will tell now about this situation. I really do hope it works out for her though, she's been through enough shit, and deserves some happiness. In retrospect, it's not how you handle things when your relationship is good. The true test of a relationship is how each person deals with it when things get hard. When I married my now ex, I was very deeply in love with him, and was absolutely sure I wanted to spend the rest of my life with him. He and I were compatible on all levels, and had a great time whatever we did. I loved his kids, like they were my own. It was meant to be, until it wasn't. I started noticing that his parenting wasn't exactly what he promised it would be, especially with my stepson. He would tell his son to do or don't do something, son would refuse, and now ex would just cave in and let him get away with it. Every single damn time. I let it go so many times. Finally I brought it up with ex that my stepson hadn't done any of his chores or cleaned his bathroom in 2 months. Ex said he'd take care of it, and then didn't, and so on. This stress, me with a very stressful job and a psycho boss at the time, led me into a mental breakdown. I'm not proud of who I was during this time. I was angry and lashing out a lot. I recognized I had a problem and went and got help, intense therapy, diagnosed CPTSD, medications, the whole works. Ex on the surface seemed to support me. I apologized and did everything I could to make it right. But it didn't matter, because he was already fucking someone else. He'd go to this woman's house after work, fuck her, and then come home before I would get home from work. He'd act like everything was fine, go into the bathroom, arrange to go to her house and fuck her, and then give me some lie about going for drinks with his guy friends. When things get hard, there are usually two reactions: pouring yourself into making yourself better and improving your life, or running away. I did the former, he did the latter. I actually took him back once, because I loved him and wanted to make our marriage work. I didn't want to lose our family or our lives together. But not 2 months later, he was fucking the other woman again. He abandoned me, his kids, his dogs, everything, and just walked out. I took care of his kids. They were young adults at that time, 19 over 24, but not self-sufficient, for a year before I finally put my foot down. It takes two people to work on a marriage. I wanted to save it, but he just wanted to run away. He never dealt with his own issues that I had no idea about. That's another story. So it ended. And now that I'm out of it and still in therapy, I'm realizing how emotionally and verbally abusive he was. He would gaslight me, set me up to fail, punish me with the silent treatment, yell at me for the most ridiculous shit and so on. I loved who I thought he was, but that person didn't exist. The lying, cheating, gaslighting, abusive person is who he actually is. I'm tearing up as I'm typing this, because this whole situation fucked me up beyond belief, and I'm going to need so much more therapy to heal from it. Meanwhile, he's still with the woman he cheated on me with and left me for twice. I hope it was worth it for him. We were in love, and she told the history of her mother not being able to forgive people, and I said good thing I've got her, and that she is completely different than her mother. We lived in our apartment, and 18 months in she told me that she dreamed of the day I would be gone. We went on some years and I noticed that just like on America's Got Talent, I was walking around with permanent big red X's over my head. She told me she loved me. She told me she did not. We made new friends, we dropped old friends. I tried to break through the wall that she built between us. We could talk about things, but I never gained access inside. But I still loved her. I became depressed, badly depressed, and we carried on. She was always kind to me. We had kids. We had a dead bedroom. Depression is not attractive, but I still loved her. I talked to guys at work who were divorced, and remember thinking, good thing, that will never happen to me, because I've got her. Depression issues came to a head, was in a bad car accident, lost my job, had health problems, but I still loved her. And then she asked me to leave. I did. I arranged a spiritual retreat for myself, and she said it was a great idea, and during the 3 weeks she got rid of all my stuff, sent it to my parents' house. I suffered depression for several years, but was getting better, when she asked for a divorce, that strangely finally broke the depression. But I still loved her, but recognized that I could never be with her, because all of the things she railed against her mother for doing she was replicating willfully in her own life. She blamed me for the whole thing, and while I acknowledge my contributions she never could. She made me, my parents, and my sister villains. My parents were terrible people who allowed her to live rent-free in their home for over a year. My sister offered free childcare, so that she could justify her actions to herself. Part of me still loves her, and always will. One specific part of me misses her terribly, but most of me is glad to be free. I do feel sympathy for her, because until she recognizes her problems within herself she will repeat them. I was easy to push around, but she remarried a cop. I don't see it lasting long. Together for 10, married for just under 2, but precariously close to a divorce at the moment. Met as teenager and we were each other's first serious relationship. I've always had emotional regulation issues, and was subject to crying jags or fits. Almost always these fits were centered around a perceived slight against me personally. She dealt with it as best she could, and I tried SELF equals REFLECTING each time, and guiding her through what I thought the problem was, but I was unknowingly carrying a lot of real bad shit from my childhood that I thought would go away the further I got away from my family. By the time I moved out, I tapered down a lot, but I began to feel resentment against her for the perception that I was pulling more of the work as it related to maintaining a home, and frustration at her habits that I didn't agree with. We've lived together for about 3 years now, and made the decision to get married and purchase a house. We did, but the frustration and resentment seemed to only amplify with it. Things needed to be cleaned, work was needed on the house, and there was overall a level of commitment involved in keeping a steadily running home that I plunged myself into. I did it for her despite her insistence that she only wanted to live with me nicely in a house instead of living in a nice house with me. To keep things short, she ended up cheating on me with my best friend that I would have over to smoke and play video games a few times a month. This continued for about 5 months, while I continued my friendship with him, and my relationship with her. She began to avoid me on the weekends, and my resentment and frustration at her absence from household chores grew, until I blew up at her one evening and she grabbed her things and left. I didn't find out about the cheating until after I told my best friend what happened and noticed he stopped reaching out to me. I confronted her about it, and she admitted it. I understand why she did it, and I think I can come back from it and continue treatment for my emotional outbursts, but I'm not sure she can, or what her motivations are for trying to make something she didn't want to work. Honestly, I have no idea. We fell madly in love at 18. We were the perfect couple for 10 years. Best friends, grade 6, fun adventures, real life plans. We were engaged, shared struggles. We never fought, ever. We never argued. We always discussed any problem that arose, and not many ever did in our 10-year relationship. But then I went away for 3 weeks. We texted daily. I missed him. He missed me. I couldn't wait to get back home to him. When I did get home, I could sense something wasn't right. I had a gut feeling that I missed him more than he missed me. I asked him about it, and he assured me I was wrong. A week after I got home, I decided to cook a nice meal and get dressed up so we could reconnect. After dinner, I asked him if he loved me. We always asked each other this, just to hear, of course, silly. Except this time he took my hand in his, looked up at me with tears in his eyes and shook his head. I thought it was a joke, so I said, "What? You don't love me anymore?" And again he shook his head. I felt my heart shattering in my chest. It's pretty simple. He fell out of love with me. I don't know when it happened or how. He never let on, never gave me any indication that anything was wrong. He said it had been a couple of months at most. He had been having doubts and his mind was made up just a few short days after I left on my trip. He didn't give me a chance to fight for us. He did all the thinking alone and presented me with the decision. I can't even be mad at him because he can't help his feelings. We broke up on November 6 last year and I'm still heartbroken. I still love him. I feel like he was the man I was meant to grow old with. I haven't given up on us yet. We still see each other regularly. I'm in our old house now actually, and we occasionally have casual sex. It's probably pathetic on my part, but I can't lie. I'm hoping I can seduce him again, make him fall in love with me again. In December he's moving away. I'm in complete denial. I can't fathom him not being close by, starting a whole new life without me in it. My life has been on standby for 9 months. She was about 12 years older than me. I saw this hot, successful, and confident woman, and I was turned on with raging early 20-something hormones. When we first got together we had constant sex, like 4 or 5 times a day. There were times when I had to nope out, just because my disco stick was feeling physically worn out, and I wanted to make sure it had a day to rest and regenerate some skin. So we got married. I loved spending time with her, obviously, and I felt like this was a sign that it was all meant to be. Well, with a man landed she gave up on her appearance. I'm not much into makeup, but I'm talking eliminating basic effort. Didn't care if she went a whole day, even to work, with bedhead. Stopped wearing her well-tailored clothes, and preferred to wear sweet pants, even if we were going out somewhere nice. She also went from hitting the gym 5 days a week, 3 days with a personal trainer, to canceling her membership entirely about a month after we got hitched. Again, we were talking about 5 days a week always getting up and getting moving to suddenly wanting to only lie on the couch, eat Nutella straight out of the jar and watch reality TV. But the biggest strain for me was that I also realized that while she had a good career she was terrible at holding down a job. She was a clinical social worker, so she could get work pretty easily, and the jobs mostly paid around the same. She'd get a job, work for a while, get fired or quit in a huff. I didn't realize this was her pattern until after we got married. She played it off. Before, like, changing jobs frequently was common in her field, because she was mainly working at smaller non-profits, and funding would run out, etc. She tried even less once we were married, and very clearly wanted to just be a housewife. Which, I could have gotten behind that maybe. I wasn't making a lot of money. Her salary was double my own. But you can make things work. But she also had expensive tastes. She had no desire to do housework or cook. So she wanted to maintain having a cleaner come in weekly, for example. Rather than discussing the housewife thing, she kind of just started doing it. Periods of unemployment gradually became longer. Then she'd get pissed off at me for not making enough money. I was fresh out of the Navy, I was finishing my degree, and I was just getting into my first adjuster job. Things were looking up, and I had a future, but she wanted me to be making double my salary right then. Once I got that first real big kid job, she pushed me to sign onto a CAD team and volunteer for extra work. She basically wanted me to focus on nothing but getting promoted as quickly as possible. Then she cheated on me. She was organizing gangbangs at our house while I was at work or away on business. When I finally caught her, she said, "What did you expect me to do? You left me here by myself." At that point, sympathy was out. I have her two options: agree to a simplified divorce in Guam, which, at the time, didn't require either of us to travel there and would be fast and cheap, provided the divorce was uncontested, or fight me in state and my attorney they would seek alimony from her. I didn't want to do the year of separation. I didn't want to go to court. I just wanted out. Thank you so much for watching the whole video. Please leave a like and subscribe.